Boker Tov, welcome. I'm Rabbi Shainer. I'm here with Temple Sinai for this morning's Boker Tov stream, our daily chance to connect, reflect, and remember together as a community. It's wonderful to start the day together, and as we do every morning, we'll begin with a prayer of gratitude for the fact that we are here. And so we'll begin by joining together. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher yatzar et ha'adam bechokhma uvaravon nekavim nekavim chalulim chalulim galui v'yadu lifnei chisek vodecha she'im yipateach echad mehem o yisateim echad mehem yefshar lehitkayim v'lamod lefanecha Baruch ata Adonai Rofe chol basar umafli la'asot. Blessed eternal God, creator of the universe, you have fashioned our bodies with wisdom, creating within us a finely balanced network. To stand before you in prayer is itself a fragile miracle. Eternal God, we praise you as the healer of body and spirit. And now, having had the opportunity to offer gratitude for our being, for our just being here and showing up, we take the time now to point out that we have an opportunity that is sacred to learn together, to stretch our minds and our hearts with words from our tradition as we say this prayer for the study of Torah. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kidshanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu la'asok b'divrei Torah. V'ha'arevna Adonai Eloheinu et divrei Toratcha b'finu u'v'fi amcha beit Yisrael v'niyeh anachnu v'tze'etza'enu v'tze'etza'e amcha beit Yisrael kulanu yod'ei shmecha v'lomdei Toratecha lishma Baruch ata Adonai ha'melamed Torah le'amo Yisrael. Blessed eternal God, creator of the universe, you sanctify our lives with mitzvot and command us to engage in Torah study. Eternal our God, may your words of Torah be sweet in our mouths. Let every generation, young and old, the whole family of Israel, come to know you through the study of Torah for its own sake. Eternal our God, we praise you as the teacher of Torah to the people of Israel. And now we engage with those words of Torah, words which come from the book of Deuteronomy, but which have been with us for generations, the words of the Shema. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Baruch Shem, Kevod Malchuto, Leolam Va'ed, Ve'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha, בכל לבבך ובכל נפשך ובכל מאודך. והיו הדברים האלה אשר אנוכי מצבך היום על לבבך. ושיננתם לבניך ודיברת בם בשבתך בביתך ובלכתך ובדרך ובשוכבך ובקומך. וקשרתם לאות על ידך והיו לטוטפות בין עיניך. וכתבתם על מזוזות ביתך ובשעריך. ויאמר אדוני אל משה לאמור, דבר אל בני ישראל, ואמרת עליהם, ועשו להם ציצית, על כנפי בגדיהם לדורותם, ונתנו על ציצית הכנף פתיל תכלת, והיה לכם לציצית, וראיתם אותו, וזכרתם את כל מצוות אדוני, ועשיתם אותם. ולא תטולו אחרי לבבכם ואחרי עיניכם, אשר אתם זונים אחריהם. למען תזכרו ועשיתם את כל מצוותיי, והייתם קדושים לאלוהיכם. אני, אדוני אלוהיכם, אשר הוצאתי אתכם מארץ מצרים, להיות לכם לאלוהים. אני, אדוני אלוהיכם. אדוני אלוהיכם, אמת. Well, The word emet means truth. And this morning, we affirm one of the truths for our people that we celebrate every month, the beginning of a new chapter, the beginning of a new leaf in our yearly cycle. And so this Rosh Chodesh today, Rosh Chodesh Av, although it is a month which begins in a kind of distress as we work towards the ninth of Av, the day of remembering the tragedies which befell our people, in particular the destruction of the two temples in Jerusalem. It is nevertheless a new month, a new chapter, and an opportunity to celebrate. And so despite the fact that we are 9 days from Tisha B'Av, we celebrate together this morning with the words from our Psalms, the words of Hallel, which say, "Praise the goodness of the Eternal, whose steadfast love is unending." Hodu l'Adonai ki tov, ki le'olam, ki le'olam chasto. Yomar na Yisrael, ki le'olam chasto. Yomru na Beit Aharon, ki le'olam chasto. Yomruna, Yomruna, Yire Adonai, ki le'olam, ki le'olam chasto. Ay-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da- dai 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 ki le olam chasado. And so now we will turn to the words of our Torah. I'm going to ask Sandra Montague to join me here on the chat. If you would turn on your video and your microphone, Sandra. Sandra is going to chant for us the verses from the Torah reading for Rosh Chodesh this morning. And so I'm going to call you up by your Hebrew name. Ta'amod ha-koreit ba-Torah mi'at.
Leora bat Abraham Basara.
Okay, so just a second here. There we go.
Vidaber Adonai, Moshe Lemohor, Sab Ebene Israel, Vamataha Alehem, Et Korbani Lakmi Hili Shai, Rech Nichoki. Tishmeru la'akribli v'modoho V'yamatalehem zeh ha'ishah Asher takribu la'anai Kevasim b'nei shanatim Shnayim la'yohom alatamid Et ha'keves echad ha'seh ba'boker V'eit ha'keves ha'shenid ha'seh ben harpayim Basiri taifa ha soleid minka belula ha v'shem minka tihit v'vit ha'hi.
As we have our Torah reading out in front of us, as we are in the middle of these verses, we take a moment to think of those who are in need of renewal, in need of healing. This morning, those who are ill and isolated and working hard to keep the rest of us safe, secure, and healthy, whose work is essential. And so we take a moment to bring all those to mind who are connected to our community and part of our community and in need of healing. And we offer this blessing for healing from our tradition, from the middle of our Torah reading. Mishaberach avotenu Avraham Yitzchak veYaakov. V'imotenu Sara Rivka Lea v'Rachel hu yerape et kol makotenu v'hiratzon milfanecha Adonai Eloheinu lehachalimam ulerapotam v'yishlach lanu mehera rufua shlema v'ateret shalom v'tagen aleinu mimachala ra'a v'nomar amen. May the one who blessed our fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, And our mothers, Sarah, Rebecca, Leah, and Rachel, heal all who suffer. May it be your will to provide healing and strength. Reveal to us the holiness of life, the wholeness of shalom, and let us say together, Amen. And we'll continue with the Torah reading. Sandra, if you would pick it up for me, that would be great.
Rech Nikoa Kishe Adonai, and he's called Vita Hihi Makedes Pahechai Bakodesh. I say, Nesechaha Adonai, the eight Makedes Ashimi Tase, then her buying to me hot a booker if he's called Tase, Ishe Rech Nikoa Adonai, Yom Pashabaha.
Yishar Koach, Sandra, thank you so much for sharing these words of Torah with us. You chanted beautifully and really helps to uplift our connection together with Rosh Chodesh this morning. We chant these words of the calendar of sacrifices on Rosh Chodesh, not because we long for a time when we will be able to offer these sacrifices again, but as a reminder to us that every relationship requires work, requires attention, requires renewal. Even the relationship between Israel and God, which in which God is a partner who needs nothing. God doesn't need to eat or drink or even to smell the reach nichoach, the beautiful, the delicious smell of food cooking on a fire. That's not what these sacrifices that we read about are all about. But what they are about is the little ways that we can show each other love. And the little ways that we can show each other that we care, because without those expressions of love, we don't know if it's real. That's what's tricky about things like love, which are true, but which are only observable in the wake of the actions that they cause us to bring. And so, just like any time, when we approach this beginning of a new month, we take this as an opportunity for renewal, an opportunity to show ourselves, our families, our community, one another, and God that what we care about, what we love, and how we move through this world. And so as we turn this chapter into the month of Av, I hope you'll join us in renewing our sense of care for one another as a community and our care for our relationship with that which is higher than ourselves. And so we will take a moment now to remember those who showed us the way and helped us to accomplish that sense of what we value by showing us that love, by caring for us, by expressing it in little ways and big ways throughout their lifetimes. This morning in particular, we are remembering and offering our condolences to the families of those who died in recent days and weeks. David Garber, Zena Werb, Robert Filler, Alan Fridson, Rose Rich, Benjamin Fruitman, and Judy Gabai. And it is our sad duty to announce the passing of Rabbi Mark Shapiro, the father of Daniel Shapiro, husband of Marcia Shapiro, son of our late Dr. Bernie and Pearl Shapiro, and the founder of our Chevrat Torah study class. Rabbi Shapiro died on Tuesday, July 21st, and the funeral arrangements are pending. This morning, we also think of those who died at this time in years past. On this first morning of the month of Av, we remember Rose Abramowitz, Herbert Martin Green, Raymond Jessel, Ida Kalb, Benjamin Mendelssohn, Harry Obrant, Francis Paul, Faye Pollock, Milton Max Pollock, Mary Shankman, Marcel Scheer, Albert Swartz, and Goldie Weisbrod. Zichronam Livracha. May their memories always bring us blessing as we turn together to words sanctified by memory, words which are glorified by hope, the words of the Kaddishia Tome. Itgadal vitkadash shmeh rabba be'alma divrach erute v'yamlich malchute b'chayechon uv'yomechon uv'chaye dechol beit Yisrael ba'agala uv'yizman kariv v'imru amen. Yehei shmeh rabba mevarach le'alam u'le'alme almaya yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yitpa'ar v'yitroman v'yitnase v'yithadar v'yitale Veit halal shmeh dekudsha brichu. Le'ela min kol birchata v'shirata, tush bechata v'nechemata, da amiran be'alma v'imru amen. Yehei shlama rabba min shmaya, v'chayim aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen. Ose shalom b'meromav, hu ya'ase shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen. May the source of peace send peace to all who mourn and comfort to all who remember, as we say together, Amen. Well, it's been wonderful to join together as a community this morning. I hope that you are able to get out there and make it a great day, and that you'll join us for Shabbat services this week at 6:30 on Friday evening and 10 a.m. on Saturday morning. Our services can be accessed via Zoom or on Facebook. And the links for all of those programs, all of those services can be found on Temple Sinai's website. Boker Tov, get out there and make it a great day.